الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله تعالى، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. Indeed, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord, the gracious, the merciful, the master of the earth and the heavens, and the king of the day of judgment, Azza wa Jal. And the prayers and the blessings of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and be upon all those who follow in the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah wahdahu la sharika lah, wa nashhadu anna Muhammadan abdullahi wa rasuluh, wa safiyuhu min khalqihi wa khaliluhu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله تعالى به الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على الحبيب المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته وسار على هديه إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I start by reminding myself and reminding you to be pious, to remember the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala and everything that you do. For he Azza wa Jal orders us when he says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Oh, you believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be God conscious, and die in no way except in the way of Islam. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَّا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Oh, you believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and let every soul be aware of its own tomorrow. And fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for he knows best what you do. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us and support us, to forgive us and guide us, to keep our feet steadfast on his path, and to make our matters easy. Allahumma ameen. My dear respected brothers and sisters, it's been a tough year. There has been a lot of events. Yesterday, we have been reminded that a year has passed since a massacre of nearly 3,000 people and the imprisonment of tens of thousands in one of our homes back in Egypt. 3,000 people who, for the month of Ramadan and the days after the month of Ramadan, were praying, were peacefully protesting, and were trying to undo an injustice that has befallen their nation only months before. We also remember that this Ramadan brings us the tragic events that have taken place in the land of Gaza and the injustice that has been afflicting our brothers and sisters there, being bombarded indiscriminately and being killed in their own homes. And the world is watching and seeing how their resistance has in fact taught us how we need to stand for justice and we need to remain steadfast. And the examples are plenty. We see it all over the world. A great deal of injustice is afflicting our brothers and sisters in Syria. The injustices are committed in the name of our deen in Iraq and in other places. The burning of Muslims for being Muslims in Burma. Many people don't know about what's called East Turkestan. Brothers and sisters in the millions their right to fast and their right to practice their religion was taken away from them. Recently, there were massacres against them. And on and on and on. Plenty of injustice. Yet we as believers in La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, may have sad emotions, and we may have difficulties processing and seeing the grave injustice that befalls us, especially our young ones. But the fact of the matter is that in our deen, we are not to feel hopeless, and we are not to feel helpless. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that against injustice, we must provide an alternative and we must uplift injustice. And our scholars teach us that there is no such thing as feeling helpless, and there is no such thing as feeling hopeless. But rather, it has to be the ability to remain steadfast and patient. But that gives the responsibility, or begets the responsibility, to must change the very reality that we find ourselves facing and the difficulties that we find. Imam Ibn Taymiyyah tells us that this is such a fundamental issue that it is tied to the very basis of saying La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. The meanings of injustice and the meanings of justice are so inherently intertwined in the very foundations of our faith that we can't turn our backs to championing the cause of justice, and we can't accept, nor live with, nor tolerate injustice. For injustice anywhere is injustice everywhere. And so when we look at the matter of tawheed, he says at-tawheed huwa aslu ad-din wa huwa a'zamu al-'adl wa ash-shirku a'zamu adh-dhulm. That even if we look at our own ibadah, our own tawheed, the fundamental alignment of the servant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most important track of setting justice in one's life. And when you associate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you commit the greatest injustice against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most high and against yourself. And that's why the scholars say that injustice is at three levels. There is an injustice between you and between the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is when you associate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna shirka la dhulmun azim. Shirk is indeed a grave injustice. And it is an injustice that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forgive. For he subhanahu wa ta'ala, inna Allah la yaghfiru an yushraka bihi wa yaghfiru ma duna dhalik. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's the ultimate sin, is to commit injustice against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most high when you commit shirk. And when you don't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala solely as the only deity worthy of worship. From that stems our resistance and our refusal to accept injustice in any other sphere of our lives. For the other two other spheres are the injustice that the human being can commit against himself when he does not follow the righteousness and the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are committing injustice against yourself when you are lying and cheating and avoiding righteousness. And so you need to forget, you need to fix that, because that's directly harming you. And the scholars say that that's an area where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will always be ready, subhanahu wa ta'ala most high in his way, to forgive you and to take your return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then there is the third realm of injustice in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never leave you without justly rewarding or punishing you on it. And that is the injustice between you and between other people. That requires the redemption of that from the person against whom the injustice was inflicted. And so when we read about injustice, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most high uses very severe language against injustice. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most high tells us, like the Prophet ﷺ tells us in the Hadith Qudsi, الظلم ظلمات يوم القيامة. Injustice is layers of darkness the day of, in the hereafter. إن الله لا يظلم مثقال ذرة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not even an atom's weight is carried as an unjust. وَمَا اللَّهُ يُرِيدُ ظُلْمًا لِلْعَالَمِينَ وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدٍ. Constantly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sets the tone for us to avoid injustice in any respect and in any way possible. And we all know the gravity of injustice when it befalls, that it is a darkness, that it is a cause for the destruction of any people that commit injustice. وَلَقَدْ أَهْلَكْنَا الْقُرُونَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَمَّا ظَلَمُوا. When they commit injustice, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put their destruction as a inevitable outcome. أَلَا لَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَى الظَّالِمِينَ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most high carries the balance and will never forget nor overlook, subhanahu wa ta'ala most high, the injustice committed. وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ اللَّهَ غَافِلًا عَمَّا يَعْمَلُ الظَّالِمُونَ. إنما يؤخرهم ليوم تشخص فيه الأبصار مهطعين مقنعي رؤوسهم لا يرتد إليهم طرفهم وأفئدتهم هواء. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts the responsibility upon us to keep that balance. For the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also one that is most high and a fundamental principle for us to follow. Al-Adl is the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that He does not keep the balance even if it was an atom's weight. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِتَائِدِ الْقُرْبَى وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغِي يَعِدُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ar-Rahman says, وَالسَّمَاءَ رَفَعَهَا وَوَضَعَ الْمِيزَانِ أَلَّا تَطْغَوْا فِي الْمِيزَانِ وَأَقِيمُوا الْوَزْنَ بِالْقِسْطِ وَلَا تُخْسِرُوا الْمِيزَانِ. Constantly calls upon us to put justice in its place. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تُؤَدُّوا الْأَمَانَاتِ أَن تُؤَدُّوا الْأَمَانَاتِ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهَا وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ أَن تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ. So for us, the fundamental issue of justice and injustice is not one just to be taken lightly. It's not one that should be brushed upon as something that we have the luxury of letting it pass and not take it as a fundamental principle that we have. So when we see what happens around us, when we see the injustice that afflicts others around us, whether it's at home, you know, here what's happening in Ferguson, Missouri, or what's happening, you know, prior to that in New York, and the issues of police brutality and the issue of racism, and those are just, they are close to us. They are very close to home. And our concern over them should be of the same principle. Now, I'm not equating the gravity of the crimes that are being committed against the tens of thousands of people in Syria and Egypt and everywhere else. But what I'm saying is it's the same principle that we must always weigh in when we consider doing something about it. And so when we look at our responsibilities as believers, and when we look at these injustices and grave transgressions, we can't let ourselves lose sight of what that should do to us. It cannot depress us. It cannot cripple us. It cannot take us away from wanting to do something about it. It cannot make us feel inept or unable to change. Because not only do we gain these principles and gain the value by which we measure what's right and what's wrong, and whether we should stand by the justice and stand against injustice from what people think or from the gravity of the crimes, we do it because it stems from our very tawheed that we say every time we raise our finger and say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. So it must be something that we live by. and we must stand by it. And we must do everything in our own capacity to bring a change and change the conditions that have allowed this to happen. And this is a lifelong struggle. This is not going to end at some point, but rather it is the test that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes for all of humanity. The question is, are we constantly on the side of the truth? Are we constantly seeking our best to make sure we make a difference? Are we constantly filled with hope and principle that we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will indeed help us and support us in our fight against injustice? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّمِينَ لِلَّهِ شُهَدَاءَ بِالْقِسْطِ. Oh, who you believe, stand for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be witnesses for justice. وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنَ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا اعْدِلُهُ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى. So our, again, engagement of this issue must be principled. Even if it's upon us, then we must abide by what is right and what's not. Even if it means a struggle and a sacrifice and a price to be paid, then it must be done, because it's not enough excuse for us to say we just can't, or we are too weak to do, or we are too far to make a difference. We must live with the principle of doing everything we can. And that could vary from one person to the other. And that could mean just writing a little email, or it could mean sacrificing your life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But whatever it is, it's a state of mind that constantly you have to realize that in order for you to perfect your tawheed, you cannot stand with injustice, and you cannot watch injustice being afflicted and not do something about it, and you cannot not have a revulsion and a stance against injustice, and you cannot say, I can't do something about it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in another place tells us, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ بِالْقِسْطِ شُهَدَاءَ لِلَّهِ. Live your lives with justice and be witnesses to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, putting the principles, وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوِ الْوَالِدَيْنِ وَالْأَقْرَبِينَ. And even if it means it's against you and against those who are near to you. But sometimes, the real challenge for us, when it's not clear how best to do things, sometimes it's very easy for you to be able to take a stance that's very clear, because the matters where you can act are, our circumstances are very clear. But ultimately, we are responsible for where we are. And we are responsible for the people around us. And we are responsible for the very society we live in. And we are responsible for the very country we live in. And indeed, we are responsible for the very world we live in. And so it becomes our challenge to figure out how best can we make a difference. And how best can we truly create the proper environment so the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is high. And so that the stance for justice is measured by the most correct of the measures that measures what justice is. And then from there, decide on how best we can make a difference. I see many of our youth sometimes boiling with the energy of the youth, not wanting to accept injustice, wanting to make a difference, and rightfully so. But they don't have the principles of our deen to guide how we can bring about a difference. Our responsibility towards removing injustice goes beyond than just stopping an act from happening. It has to be that plus changing the very people that are grown to accept injustice or commit injustice. It has to be about removing the chains of this life from people's minds and hearts, so that they realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the source of justice, and they realize that their transgressions against the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala is the very reason and the very source for their injustice. And so it is about changing hearts and minds. It is about educating. It is about standing for the truth. Even though it may not be the easy stance, it is about committing all that plus being ready at a moment's notice to sacrifice one's time, money, and life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hand in hand. And so we as Muslim Americans, challenged by transgressions we see all around us, challenged sometimes by faulty policies that we see as a reason for many of these problems, yet the frustration that results from rejecting it or taking a strong stance against it is not good enough. Because ultimately it has to stem from a heart that realizes that we're responsible for it as well. We live in a polity, in a nation, in a country where we have chosen to be citizens that respect its laws, live by its norms, commit to the protection of the principles that we believe fit our ideals and our beliefs. And we are empowered as believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fortify these positions even more by knowing that when we stand for justice, it's not because it's just the letter of the law. It's because it's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us to do. And so that obligates us to understand that for us to not work diligently to change the very policies that we think are wrong, to make a difference by using the influence that our nation has upon the world, whether it's the in all of the realms, and making a difference about what happens, whether it's in Gaza or Egypt or Burma or Turkestan or anywhere in the world, that we cannot absolve ourselves from the responsibility to change and the responsibility to carry on the ways and means by which we can become involved and which we become responsible and take ownership of the very destiny that we call our own when we live in this land and when we accept to be within a society that is ruled in these norms and in these policies. And so when we look at the expansive nature of our deen, we realize it's the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's guidance is not just for us, it's for all of humanity. And it is about improving the human condition. And it's about making sure that people live a life with the highest standards of decency and humanity. And so by transforming oneself and by transforming people around you and by raising your children to understand the essence and the importance of this deen to us, but in peace and harmony with your own environment, so that you can have a position of influence, so that you can have a way of compassion, so that you can transform the conditions of the people around you. Not to create the understanding of the ways that will create the separation that will keep you away from change and giving you the poor excuse of pointing the finger on the other and saying that they are doing it. There is no such thing as they and we. We are all a we in the same environment. And what happens across the street in Washington is a responsibility of those who are praying in Dar al-Hijrah. And if they don't take that responsibility and figure out the ways to change, if it's education, we will put our children in Harvard and Yale and the best of schools in this country. If it's being part of the political process, we will vote, we will change, we will talk to politicians, and we will make sure we bring forth our own politicians. If it's policy change, we need to craft how the US engages the Muslim world. We need to be the ones making the policies that makes the difference in the lives of people all over the world, Muslim world or otherwise, but in accordance with the greater balance of justice that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us to do. If it's our tax money that goes to commit and afflict the damage on innocent people, then we must be the ones holding back and changing those policies. If the aggression of minorities or the aggression of foreign powers over our nation's conscience and our nation's moral compass, then we must change it. We must stand against it. We must make a difference in it. That's how we say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. That's how we are inspired by our prayers and services in Ramadan and outside of Ramadan. Because we know the forehead that bows to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall not bow to anybody else. But that's how we make a difference. That's how we inspire our children. That's how we answer their questions on how can we change the injustice that afflicts our brothers and sisters across the ocean. And not give them these limited visions that makes no sense. It goes against our own deen. And it makes no difference or change in the lives of others, but gives us maybe the poor excuse to feel that we're excused. We don't have a responsibility. We can't make a difference. All we have to do is hit the wall. But that's not acceptable. Because the balance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created was based on justice. And those who are free, and those who are capable, and those who have the means must be the ones more responsible about attaining it than the poor ones who have their homes broken and destroyed upon their heads. My dear brothers and sisters, we are in need to transform our way of looking at things and our way of owning up to the very responsibility that we must own up to. We don't just live a life by the codes of Islam. We live a mission that is inspired upon us when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us the vicegerents on this earth. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us Ansarullah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us Qawwameena lillah shuhada bilqist. It is upon us when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that injustice against anybody is injustice that is not acceptable. Then and only then are we able to look inside, make the difference, change ourselves, so that inshallah, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will see a day inshallah when the justice that we seek will be the balance by which we measure our lives. When the injustice we seek to remove will be bi-idhnillah removed from the Holy Land and from all over the world. If we're true to ourselves, if we are true to our commitment, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to strengthen our hearts, to keep our feet steadfast, to enable us to insha'Allah fulfill our mission and stand for justice. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه الصلاة والسلام على الحبيب المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته وسار على هديه إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters, enough said. It is time to act. It is time to build on what we all know. For the student to excel in his studies. For the worker to do the best he can. For people to go beyond their own limits, their own concerns, their own living quarters, and to make a difference in the public square, to make a difference in the lives of others, and to make a difference in the people's, in the lives of the people around us, changing and transforming, not just living and emulating the old traditions, but rather making a difference so that everybody, every single day, is truly transformed. Every single day, you make a difference in somebody's life. You make a difference in your own life. You make a difference in your own society. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide our people, to guide our society, to guide our country, to guide and to take the wrath from the lives of the people who are suffering. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept the martyrs who have been martyred, to forgive the sins of those who are the sinners, to support those who are suffering. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us and guide us. Allahumma afu anna waghfir lana warhamna. Anta maulana fansurna ala alqawm alkafirin. Allahumma ahdina wahdi bina. Allahumma ati nufusana taqwaha. Wazakkiha maulaya anta khayru man zakkaha. Anta waliyuha wa maulaha. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعدكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وقوموا إلى الصلاة يرحمكم الله وأقم الصلاة الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قل اللهم مالك الملك تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء بيدك الخير إنك على كل شيء قدير تولج الليل في النهار وتولج النهار في الليل وتخرج الحي من الميت وتخرج الميت من الحي وترزق من تشاء بغير حساب الله أكبر